Hi, I'm James Schillinglaw, and I'm here with a familiar face if you've been watching us over the years. It's Allison Gilmore, who's the Portfolio Director for ILTM Events. And we just finished the ILTM North America, but guess what's coming up? It's ILTM Con, the mothership. And we're all getting ready to go, and we thought we'd take a moment to speak with Allison about ILTM Con and what's going on, and you're going to find out about all that on Insider Travel Report. First of all, Allison, obviously this is a very different year. It's going to be the first, it's the first ILTM Con in 2 years. What is the feedback you're getting from those seeking to attend ILTM Con? Are suppliers and buyers getting really excited to get back to in-person events?
Oh, hi, James. Nice to be back with you. They really are. The excitement is building. We've only got 8 weeks now to go till we get to Cannes. And yeah, all I can say is it's like Christmas. You know, we all want to be back together. We've all been starved of that connection within the industry. And the excitement is definitely there, not only from me and my team, but from the exhibitors and the buyers. So I think we're in for a good event. Like you say, the first one in 2 years, and none of us can wait.
Yeah, well, I know, having been at ILTM North America, everyone was so happy to be back together again. And certainly there didn't seem to be any hesitancy about it. I was there. And of course, as you can see from my background, I'm already getting in the spirit of things. I'm already at the Carlton in Cannes, the Intercontinental Carlton in Cannes. But you just told me that one's going to be closed this year, which is kind of interesting because we've been talking about that for years. They're going to be renovating until 2023, right?
Yep, that's correct. And it's a beautiful hotel. And luckily, they're not changing any of that beautiful facade that's behind you. But they're upgrading it. And I think it's, you know, the Martinez has been upgraded, the Majestic's been upgraded, and it's time for the Carlton. And it'll be a stunning hotel when it's done. It's just unfortunate.
We're looking forward to it, but I always put it up because for me, it's kind of the symbol, one of the symbols of Cannes. And so I did put that up getting in the spirit of things because I'm getting ready to go to. Now, what if anything did your team learn from its recent experience at ILTM North America?
I think they learned that, you know, everybody was happy to be back together despite having to wear face masks indoors and, you know, have COVID tests and checks and show your QR codes. You know, that's something we've never had to do before, but the team managed it really well. I have to say, Mexico was on the red list for the UK, so I personally wasn't able to get there, but Simon Mayle and the team did an awesome job. But yeah, I think just having everybody be aware that, you know, we do have to do these things, and it's not us that are putting these rules in. It is the governments in, and, you know, we'll have some of the similar precautions in Cannes. But long as everybody, you know, does their bit, it makes it so much easier. And with everyone being so excited to be back together, you know, it's a small price to pay for getting this industry back on its feet and getting everyone back together again.
No, absolutely. It really isn't that much. You get a test, you get your vax card, and you wear a mask, and you fill out the worst. I'm finding the worst thing about international travel today is filling out the health forms for every single country. Mm-hmm. They're all different, and they're all online, which is sometimes a little complicated. Now, let's talk about Cannes. How many participants do you expect in Cannes, and how does that break down in terms of buyers and suppliers?
Well, we're looking at about 1,400 exhibitors and 1,400 buyers, so 2,800 people, which is a lot. It's down on 2019, but that's to be expected. But that's just the people that have got diaries. Then obviously there's people like yourself, there's the media, there's all the additional badges. So we're expecting a good number this year. Let's say it will be slightly down on 2019, but it's coming back, and it's come back a lot stronger than we thought it would.
Yeah, no, that's great. And I know everybody's going to be happy to get back there. Now, what is going to be different with ILTM Con, if anything, due to this pandemic? I assume we're going to have to go through some of the similar health and safety precautions protocol that you are to protect all the delegates, right?
Yes, we are. And we're going to be doing, so you have to show a QR code, which can be your own country's vaccine program, or you can go and have an antigen test in France and put it on the French app. You show that, and every day we'll have a different coloured wristband that gets you into the event just to prove that you've been through the security and you've been through the test. You know, we have to wear, right now we do have to wear masks within the venue. That may change by December. But to be honest, there's not a lot of other things that have changed. I've already been down to Cannes and attended two events, and it was very easy. It was very seamless. You know, and having to put a mask on is no big deal.
No, I agree.
So really, there's not a lot of change.
No, that's great. And you'll accept those flimsy little vaccination cards we have here in the States that look like we printed them last week?
Well, it's whether the French will accept them for you to get into France. But long as they're genuine, obviously everybody we are inviting, we know most of them. So we're trusting people to be honest and genuine with their vaccine cards. But yeah, long as you've got some proof, or, you know, we're going to have some testing facilities on site too. So if anybody is worried, they can pop into the place and get a test, and that'll go on a QR code. So we've got plenty of backup plans if people lose their little flimsy card that they made last week, or, you know, just want to get another test.
No, absolutely. And of course, when we all return, here in the States, we need our antigen test to get back in. But I don't know. I may just keep going and after this and go find some other places to go to. We'll see.
Well, you can have your antigen test in Cannes before you leave. So that will all be done. It's all on site ready for you.
That's great. Now, we did talk a second ago about the hotels. The Intercontinental Hotel Carlton will be closed, but the rest of the hotels are all open. And you said so many of them have been recently renovated.
So, yep, the Carlton will be closed. The Grand will also be closed, which is just along from the Carlton, just set back a little bit. Another lovely hotel. That one's also closed. But the JW Marriott recently opened, and it's beautiful. It's very different.
I remember the last time we were there, it was a construction zone. I remember that was 2 years ago.
It was, but it's no longer a construction zone. It's beautiful. Really, they've done a wonderful job on that. So that's great. As you know, the Martinez had a refurb 2 years ago. Still looking beautiful. And the Majestic had one a few years ago as well. So, you know, all the hotels are in really good shape. And once we get the Carlton back online, the whole of the Croisette will be sparkling with lovely hotels.
Well, it is. I remember last year also, 2 years ago, I keep saying last year, 2 years ago, they had were really refurbishing the Croisette itself. You know, mm-hmm. all I remember there's some lovely photos of famous movie stars all up and down the Croisette that was basically hiding some of the refurbishments going on the wonderful walk. It was great, actually.
Well, that's finished. The Croisette is open. The beaches are all finished. We have extended the beach depth by about 30 meters to give them nice bigger beaches. All the hotels have got their restaurants down on the beach. There's some beautiful restaurants on there. And as you know, fingers crossed, most of the time in December, we get a bit of sunshine, so we can go and have lunch on the beach. So that's going to be great this year because it is all finished. There is no construction along the Croisette, and it's so nice.
Yeah, and I know we have many events, I know, in some of those beach restaurants, so it's good. It'll be great to get back to them. And yeah, mm-hmm. You're right. Usually the weather is pretty good. I think last year the rains came just before, and then we were able to have a wonderful 4 or 5 days there with really a lot of sun. There was not a bit of rain at all. Not maybe ready for swimming yet, but still nice to be out there. So
yeah, a little bit chilly for swimming. But you know, if you're into cold water swimming, you know, go for it. But yeah, go on.
Yeah, sorry. One of the things I wanted to ask you about was, are you having an opening general session with speakers like you normally do?
We are. I was actually there's an event going on in Cannes at the moment called MIPCOM, which is for the TV industry. And I've just been watching one of their big conferences in the auditorium where we have it. Yes, we're planning ours. We're just finalizing our speakers at the moment. So yes, we will be having a nice opening forum followed by an opening party and a closing party on the Thursday. So the program is going to stay roughly the same.
That's great. No, I'm looking for it. So basically pretty much the same except for masks and vaxes and stuff.
Yeah.
Now, to your knowledge, are suppliers still hosting sort of separate evening parties, dinners, lunches at ILTM Con? Are you hearing that there?
As far as I'm aware, yes, they are. You know, we've been talking to some of the venues which are booked up, which is great. You know, they're already getting booked up. There was one restaurant I wanted to book up and couldn't. So someone's already booked that. So, you know, hey, it's good news.
Well, I know that's always a challenge. You know, you're trying to find a place to hold your event, and things get booked up pretty fast. And it sounds like this year is going to be no different. So that's good news in a way. You know, bad news if you haven't made your reservation, I guess, right?
There's always space. There's always some things. It might just not be your first choice. But as you know, there's some beautiful places in Cannes. There's some lovely little restaurants, and there's some bigger places. So there's always something.
Absolutely. Now, what is the theme of this year's ILTM Con, and how does it reflect sort of luxury travel's comeback after the pandemic?
Well, we've been batting themes back and forward, and we decided we just wanted to welcome everybody back. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're going to have lots of welcome signs everywhere. I don't know if you remember a few years ago, we did a little heart. We did a pin that was a little heart. We're going to do that again this year because we just want, you know, we want to feel the love. We want everyone back together. We want to take care of everybody. And I think that's what everybody needs after the last 2 years. So our theme is, you know, it's back to love and just taking care and welcome everyone back. Simple as that.
Absolutely. And we are going to be happy to be back now. Are you getting a sense, and I don't know whether your theme reflects it, but is luxury travel kind of emerging from the pandemic in a much more sustainable form? I know that's been a theme in the past at ILTMs, but is that your sense? Because, you know, we're all saying, I'm hearing a lot, and we did talk about it in Mayakoba and ILTM, at ILTM in North America. But it is rather amazing that, you know, people are refocusing on sustainability even as we emerge from this.
No, I think you're right. I think they are. Obviously, I've been in the luxury travel industry a very long time, and it's very hard, and it always is always the fastest part of the industry to come back quickest. But I think after the last 2 years, after we've seen the planet, you know, heal itself while we've all been indoors, I think it would be wrong if we didn't focus on sustainability. And I think it's such a big part of all our lives now, it would be wrong if it wasn't. So we're going to do our little bit to make sure that, you know, we're contributing and we're helping the industry be more sustainable as well.
No, that's great. And it definitely was something we heard in Mexico a few weeks ago. And I know that we'll hear it in Cannes in December. Yeah. Now, what do you hope sort of luxury suppliers and buyers will get out of this year's event after 2 years? I mean, what do you think is going to be the mood and what can they find when they get there?
Well, I think the mood is going to be, you know, quite celebratory. I think everybody is, you know, like we said before, they're excited to be back. I think it's getting back to those connections, seeing people we've not seen for 2 years. You know, 2 years is a long time. And our job is to help people get back to business. You know, people now with more and more countries opening up, people are beginning to travel. I mean, I know the UK, you know, everyone here is desperate to travel, probably the same in the US. So I think that, you know, the business is going to come back and it's going to come back fast. So I think it's getting everyone prepared, getting those relationships back, finding new properties, going back to your clients that you may not have worked with for, you know, the last 18 months to 2 years and taking them some new offerings. So I think there's going to be lots to discover at ILTM as well as, you know, a lot of the normal stuff that's there all the time. But, you know, it's about rebuilding those relationships. And just basically getting back to business. Because at the end of the day, that's what we're all in. We're all in a business.
Absolutely. And I know we're all looking forward to that. I certainly am. You know, it was great to see the smaller version. But we had a pretty good attendance down at ILTM North America. And now we're going to Cannes, which is always an event I look forward to every year. Now, can suppliers and buyers still apply to attend ILTM Cannes? And if so, where can they go to do so?
If they're quick, they can. So we've actually finished selling last week, but we have a week of just, you know, sort of mopping up, if you like. So if anybody is interested, buyers or sellers, please go to our website, iltm.com, and all the information is on there. We have, obviously, you know this, we have the appointment system. And one of the reasons we stopped selling and we stopped recruiting buyers is so that we can start the match and get all the information in together. So we have got a little bit of time, so if there's any buyers out there that go, do you know what, I've not been for a few years and we've not invited you this year for whatever reason, or you've moved company, let us know. You know, and if we can fit you in, we absolutely will. You've got nothing to lose by asking. And if you don't get in this year, we'll have you on the list for next year.
Absolutely. So go to www.iltm.com and see what's up, and maybe we can get in there and it'll be great. I'm all signed up myself. I'm looking forward to it.
Good.
As usual. We are going to have a great time in Cannes. Allison, it'll be great to see you in Cannes and good luck with the next few weeks. I know they're going to be very busy, which is a good thing, right?
It is a good thing, James. Look forward to seeing you too. I'm also signed up, ready to go. So we've got a busy few weeks ahead, but it's exciting. It's that really nice, busy, exciting time. It's a lot of work, but you know, it's worth it at the end of the day. In 8 weeks time when we're open, it's going to be fabulous.
Well, we all missed it last year when we couldn't do it. So as busy as it may be, I always think, count your lucky stars, as they say, and that we're back. So again, Allison, yes. Great to see you. We'll see you in Cannes. And I am James Schillinglaw for Insider Travel Report.